Aromatherapy essential oil treatments are really popular for hair loss. And in this video, I'm going to show you not only the research themselves, but the actual before and after pictures so you can hopefully save money and time and frustration trying to find something that works for you. Okay, so let's begin our discussion by talking about pumpkin seed oil and its effect on hair loss. So in this study, you're looking at 76 men with hair loss problems are given either 400 milligrams of pumpkin seed oil or a placebo, and this study lasts for 6 months, which is more than enough time to see if this is going to work or not. Now, it's reported in this study that men taking pumpkin seed oil supplements showed about a 40% increase in the average number of hairs that were counted on their scalp after using pumpkin seed oil for 6 months. Okay, sounds good, but what did the before and after pictures show us? So here is one of these pictures of one of the guys in this study, and where on the left, you see him before using pumpkin seed oil, and on the right is that same guy 6 months later. Do you see a difference? Myself, I think there's a big difference, and I don't think you can explain it away by just saying that they were combing the hair differently. I think that there is some effect going on here with pumpkin seed oil. And here's a picture of another guy in this study where you can also see a difference. Although I would say in this picture, the results from pumpkin seed oil are less dramatic than in the first picture I showed you. And here's a picture of a third guy in this study, which also appears to show pumpkin seed oil supplements are having some effect on hair growth. Okay, sounds good, but our story doesn't end here because here's another clinical trial of pumpkin seed oil, but this time they're comparing its hair growth effects to that of minoxidil. This time we have 60 women, they're in their 30s, they're dealing with hair loss, they're split into two groups. One group is using pumpkin seed oil, 1 milliliters each day, massaged into their scalp, and another group is using 5% of minoxidil, again, massaged into their scalp, and the study lasts for 3 months. Here's a before and after picture of one of the women in this study. Just as before, on the left, you see her before using pumpkin seed oil treatment, and on the right is that same woman 3 months later. What do you think? Now, just as contrast, here is a woman who is using minoxidil every day for 3 months. On the left, you see her before using minoxidil, and on the right, you see that same woman 3 months later. And absolutely, you can see a significant difference in hair growth after using minoxidil for 3 months. Okay, so what would be better, pumpkin seed oil or minoxidil? So here are the before and after pictures of the two women I just showed you side by side. The picture on the top you're looking at is after using pumpkin seed oil for 3 months, and below that is the hair growth you see from a woman using minoxidil for 3 months. Now, if you ask me, minoxidil wins this challenge. However, I cannot deny that it does appear that pumpkin seed oil is in fact doing something also to help regrow hair. Okay, so much for pumpkin seed oil. Let's now move on to rosemary oil. And here is the study that first got everybody's attention. 100 men in their 20s, and they're using either 2 milliliters of 2% minoxidil or 2 milliliters of rosemary oil on their scalps each day for 6 months. So this is basically a rosemary oil versus minoxidil study. Okay, so what do the before and after pictures show us? So here is one of the pictures of a guy in this study. On the left, you see him before using rosemary oil, and on the right, you see that same guy 3 months later. Now, if you ask me, I absolutely see a difference in rosemary oil treatment that I don't think can be explained away by simply combing the hair differently. It does look like something's happening with rosemary oil. Okay, so now let's compare that to a guy who is using minoxidil. So if we look at this picture, the pictures you see on the bottom part of your screen is the guy who is using minoxidil, and it does look like he's got more coverage on his head than the guy who is using rosemary oil. So even if we assume that neither of these guys got a haircut in the previous 3 months, it does look to me as if when you compare rosemary oil to minoxidil, that minoxidil wins this battle. Now, this paper has gotten a lot of attention over the years, and while they did have 100 people in this study, I'm disappointed that they only chose to show us one picture of a guy using minoxidil and another guy using rosemary oil. In other words, why didn't they show us more pictures? Another problem with this study is that they are showing us the hair growth effects of rosemary oil or minoxidil after 3 months. However, this paper lasted for 6 months. And the other thing that jumps out at me with this paper is that they're comparing rosemary oil to 2% minoxidil. Well, wait a minute, minoxidil comes in two strengths, 2% and 5%. Why the heck did they not choose 5% minoxidil? And I don't know why they didn't do that. But it is what it is, and so let's leave rosemary oil alone for a while and now turn our attention to the ability of peppermint oil to regrow hair. So peppermint oil has also gotten its share of attention, and I think a lot of it is probably due to the study you're looking at here with a very no-nonsense title, Peppermint Oil Promotes Hair Growth. However, great title notwithstanding, this study is not relevant to you and I because it involves peppermint oil and regrowing hair in mice. And this is really important because despite the popularity of peppermint oil, regrowing hair, it's kind of all over the internet. I see these products popping up all over the place. I can't find any research showing that peppermint oil regrows hair on the heads of human beings. And that's weird because this mouse study that I'm telling you about here, it came out in 2014. So you would think that a peppermint oil worked so well that somebody somewhere would have done some research to prove that it actually works, but I can't find it. So based on that, don't waste your money on peppermint oil until better proof comes out. Now that brings us to the next essential oil hair growth treatment, and that is lavender oil, where the original research, from what I can determine, goes all the way back to the last century, 1998, where 86 people with hair loss are given a combination of oils, including lavender oil. Now, this combination of oil included lavender oil, cedarwood oil, rosemary oil, and thyme oil, which were massaged into the scalps of people each day for 7 months. So it's reported that 44% of the people using this essential oil combination had significant regrowth of their hair. And as further proof, they show us this very dramatic picture of a guy who appears to have went from being bald to having a full head of hair. Now, as impressive as this essential oil combination appears to be, the crazy thing is that I can't find any other corroborating research of this, which is strange because this paper appears to show a potential cure for baldness. Now, we do have this other study, which came out several years later, which tested the effects of a combination of lavender oil, thyme oil, rosemary oil, cedarwood oil, and evening primrose oil, and its effect on hair loss. 40 men and women are given this combination of oils for 3 months to see how well it worked. And as proof that this essential oil combination works, they show us this picture, which does show greater coverage of a bald spot, but that's the only picture they show us in this study. Now, what this means is that despite the hype of lavender oil regrowing hair, I can't find any clinical evidence of lavender oil by itself regrowing hair. And that's weird. And that brings us to a product that I would bet 99% of people watching this video have never heard of, and that's raspberry ketones. Now, I would bet that many people have heard about raspberry ketones and weight loss, thanks mostly to Dr. Oz, who many years ago called it a weight loss miracle. And by the way, I don't think raspberry ketones help people lose weight. But what about raspberry ketones growing hair? Well, here's the proof. Now, this study you're looking at has two parts. There's a mouse study part and there's a human study part. Let's bypass the mice and just focus on what happened when people used raspberry ketones topically on their head. So this is a pretty small study, and it involved only 10 men and women who are given either a placebo or a 0.1% solution of raspberry ketones that are massaged into their scalps each night for 5 months. And I'll just say before going any further that the hair growth results in one of the people in this study was nothing short of astounding. Here are the before and after pictures of four of the people in this study who were using raspberry ketones, showing a variable degree of hair growth. However, it is the final picture you're seeing that looks almost too good to be true. So dramatic picture notwithstanding, this is the only study of raspberry ketones and hair growth that I was able to uncover. And this this paper came out in 2008, which, given the dramatic results that one person had, it's strange again that no one has tried to replicate these findings. Now let's turn our attention to another potential hair growth product, and this is one that I don't think many people would want to be doing long term, and that is onion juice. So here's the study that got a lot of attention on the internet, where onion juice was given to people with alopecia areata. 62 men and women with alopecia areata are split into two groups. One group uses tap water massaging the skin, and the other group is using onion juice from Australian brown onions, again, massaged in the scalp twice a day for 8 weeks. So the part of this study that got everybody's attention was that at 6 weeks, 87% of the guys using onion juice showed a significant regrowth in their hair, and that's the word they actually used, regrowth. Okay, so as impressive as that sounds, this study also has some issues. Number one, how much onion juice were they actually using in this paper? And they don't tell us that. I didn't see it when I read the study. Also, there was a significant amount of people who dropped out of the study. It was about 50% did not complete the study. And I kind of get why you're putting onion juice on your head. And that's why I said in the beginning, I don't think many people would want to do this. And then the other problem with this study, and this is the biggest one in my opinion, is there's no before and after pictures. So even though they're saying 87% are showing more hair growth, let me judge for myself. Show me before and after pictures. And they failed to do that. And just as we've seen before in some of these other clinical trials, this paper came out in 2002. Why hasn't anybody else tried to replicate these findings and see if onion juice really does regrow hair? Okay, so we covered a lot of things in this video. What do I suggest? So the first thing I would say is minoxidil. While there is some studies out there showing that some of these treatments may work as well as minoxidil, maybe, none of them have shown evidence that they are superior to minoxidil. That said, if you are looking for something natural to help slow down hair loss or promote maybe even some hair growth, I would say take a look at pumpkin seed oil, either pumpkin seed oil supplements or the oil massage into the head, because so far there are two clinical trials that appear to show it may help. Hopefully this video helps save you some time, money, and frustration. Don't forget to subscribe and take a look at all the other videos below in the link for the other hair loss products that I've reviewed.